All right, the signs of heat exhaustion include dizziness, lightheadedness, and nausea.
Emergency room doctors say it's not always that easy to detect in children, so the best advice they give is to prevent getting dehydrated. Here's Haley Hernandez to tell us how.
Dr. Shabana Woolley, a UT Health emergency room physician, says heat exhaustion is the most common illness that comes into the ER every summer, and she doesn't want it to happen to you.
I think the best way to do that is to prehydrate.
She says before you ever go outside, make sure you're getting plenty of water every day. That looks like this. Half your body weight in ounces. But don't worry, that includes hydrating foods.
About 20% of our daily intake of water actually comes from food.
These foods are all mostly made up of water, so they're perfect summertime snacks. The most hydrating is...
The most hydrating vegetable that you can eat is probably a cucumber that has about 91% water content. The most hydrating fruit is probably watermelon. Right, that's where the name come from. Cantaloupe, tomatoes, pineapple here, all very water rich and great snacks to bring along.
But if you start to feel dizzy, tired, and weak in the sun, the most important thing to do is get to shade.
I think if you just take a rest, remove any extra layers of clothing, sit underneath a fan, and drink these two bottles of water over the course of 10 minutes, you should start to feel better.
Two water bottles in 10 minutes is about the magic number that you need to get back on track to start feeling a little bit better.
Yeah, the doctor does not recommend drinking sports drinks to hydrate. She says leave that to the extreme athletes like marathoners, professional football players, NBA players who spend a lot of time in the sun every day. Mm-hmm.